God nearby, declares the Lord, and not a God far away. Can anyone hide in secret places so that I cannot see them? Declares the Lord. Do I not feel the heaven and the earth? Declares the Lord. And this is Jeremiah speaking. Understand that Jeremiah is a prophet. The prophets were the mouthpiece of God. God always spoke through them to give a word to the people of God. Amen. So that's why Jeremiah is talking like this. He's responding to something having been said or done to the people of God in Jeremiah 23, 23, and 24, if you want to double check what I'm talking about. God's transcendent nature. Somebody say transcendent. God's transcendent nature strives to keep him distant and remote from his creation, both in space and in time. That's God's transcendent nature. He's way up there. He's way out there. He's way over there. And yet, I'm talking about something that's so profound about God, something that's going to answer your question. Is he or is he not in the daily events of mankind?
Give him what you owe him.
And yet, on the other hand, his imminent,
give him what
I want you,
you
to say imminent. Nature wants to draw him near to his creation. So you got this and that. You got him afar off and transcendent by definition and by the fact of who he is. Holy and divine and almighty and omniscient. Present, all powerful, everywhere at the same time, and yet, on the other hand, he draws near to his people as they draw near to him. Wow, that's deep, really. So his imminent nature works to draw him near to his creation and to sustain the universe. God's love, somebody say love, for his creation is so great that we see his imminence overshadowing his transcendence. Are y'all still with me? Come on now. Don't get come on. I need you to be like a sponge. Let the water spill, just soaking it all up. His imminence overpowers and overshadows the transcendence. This becomes clearly visible. And his infinite Son, Jesus Christ, as he breaks through the barrier of sin and separation, we find in another book in Genesis, we have been separated from God.
Somebody send the praise to the nation.
He created Eve. He says that good that man be alone. He placed them in the paradise. They didn't have to worry about anything. They didn't have to worry about how the rich was going to get paid. They didn't have to worry about half of
yes, church.
Church. The church. And to the Bible, I'm going to pray. They paid everything. Somebody say everything. They paid it all. Like somebody who won the battle, but 5 years later, just to say they go bankrupt. Adam and Eve went bankrupt spiritually.
Because
she was controlled by the devil to eat of the only thing that God told them not to eat of. Only because he was trying to protect them from sin that had already entered the world.
It's what I do.
So it's no longer.
Somebody send a praise to me.
So here we have it from the infinite. It's an incarnate praise. Because the Virgin Mary had not had sex. That's how it becomes incarnate. Because it wasn't the biological way that men and women conceived. So here we have Jesus Christ, and he breaks through the barrier of sin and separation to draw
Amen.
So although God is transcendent, he is also imminent. He's in the daily affairs of mankind.
Yes,
so you might be saying,
Yes, he is.
Then how come I had that accident? How come this happened? And how come that happened when he's in the daily affairs of mankind? Romans 8:28 tells me, for we know that all things work together for good for those who what?
Amen.
Love God and are called according to his purpose, not according to your purpose. Not according to your purpose or your purpose. Take your purpose and you sit it on the back seat.
Amen.
You better check with God about the purpose of your life.
Amen.
So, where was I at? Okay. As well, we see God not only choosing to just draw near to his creation, but to personally come into the hearts and the minds of his people. Personally, we believe by faith. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
We receive Jesus Christ as being the Son of God. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And then we become reconciled back to him. Back to him. But it's a choice. It's a choice.
Amen.
It's a choice to receive Jesus Christ. Don't do it because Big Mama did it. Don't do it because Mama did it. Do it because you have that little faith as the grain of a mustard seed on the inside of you and get to know him for yourself. Then he will be imminent in your life. And you might be saying right now, which is human nature, human frailty, where was God when this happened to me? And where was God when that happened to me? God gives us free will.
Yes, he does.
God gives us free will.
Yes.
And sometimes we take that free will and we go to some places where we should not go. And he'll give you a reminder. He'll give you a reminder. He'll speak. But sometimes we're so wrapped up in the doing our own thing, and the devil helping him along, opening doors for you that never should have been opened. That's the devil's job, is to kill your seed, to kill my seed. That's the devil's job. Y'all following me?
Come on. Amen. Come on. Come on, friends.
So, okay. This is a miracle of God's transcendence. Is his son, Jesus Christ. Now, let me break this down just a little bit more because I don't want to lose you. Transcendence is to exist above and independent from, to rise above, to surpass, to succeed. By this definition, God is the only true transcendent being. On the other hand, he shows up in the face of our what? Adversity, in the face of our trials, in the face of our tribulation, in the face of our tests, he shows up and I show down. Because it has not been unto death or demise. And you're still standing.
Amen.
And we're blessed. Let me tell you, this is all kind of stuff I do when I'm driving during the week. Because I don't want to forget it. Uh-huh. Don't try it. Okay. We're blessed.